Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, and welcome to Spotlight. The Australian Muslim community has made many contributions and achievements to the Australian society over the years, but no one doubts that there are always challenges heading into the future. Over the weekend, imams and scholars from around the country met in Sydney for the second annual ANIC conference. OnePath Network was invited for this exclusive report. ANIC, or the Australian National Imams Council, is the highest body of the Islamic leadership here in Australia. Established in 2006, ANIC acts as an umbrella organisation consisting of a council of imams representing each Australian state and territory. The three-day conference had over 50 imams attend and discuss the way forward for the Muslim community here in Australia.
Actually, seeing all the mashayikh from all over Australia and from various really schools of thoughts and various attitudes and mentalities, and the positive energy in the rooms, it creates excitement in me. It really gives me hope for the future.
One of the main things that ANIC is aiming for is to unite the Muslim community with the differences of backgrounds that they have, at least to be united on common grounds that the Muslim community all agrees to.
يعني يمكن أنا ذكرت في كلمة اليوم أنه أخطر ما تصاب به أمة أن تعيش بلا رأس ولا رمز ولا مرجعية.
In an unprecedented show of unity, the imams stopped their busy schedules to reflect on the year that was, what was done well, the areas of improvement, and the challenges moving forward.
Very pleased to see all the imams. They are together now. We are talking the same objective, with the same goal, and I'm really appreciate for all the imams' time. They come from all over the Australia.
I think it's spectacular. There's been a variety of opinions and ways to go forward with regard to this national body that represents imams and the masjids, mosques, various Islamic centres all around Australia. So I think it's been really, really exciting.
One presenter during the conference mentioned that over 700 years of combined Islamic clergy experience was present at the conference. Seminars, workshops and discussions were conducted over the 3 days about the challenges faced by the Muslim community, with solutions proposed and working committees formed.
So we are, inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the right path, and we hope that we'll achieve a lot out of that. And it's not just the only meeting, it's committees after this conference to follow up and have the works which is in relation of their committees in different ways. So we hope, inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will be enough at this stage to say that the Muslims are in the right direction, inshallah.
I think the role of ANIC in this context is that it gives the Australian community, as well as government, a focus point where they can actually come to understand Australian Muslims, but more than just that, also about Islam and the contribution of Australian Muslims to this country.
This conference marks a much needed step forward for the Muslim community in Australia, not only in terms of unity, but also in leadership and direction, promising high hopes for the future.
من قاعة اجتماع مجلس الأئمة في باس هيل نزف إلى الجالية الإسلامية بشرى اجتماع الأئمة من كافة ولايات إسرائيل للمرة الثانية على التوالي، وإنجازات طيبة ومشاريع مهمة للجالية. فقط الذي نريد من الجالية أن تدعو لنا بأن يحفظنا ويوفقنا لما فيه مصلحة الجالية في الدنيا والآخرة.
Thank you for watching. Do send us an email to spotlight@onepathnetwork.com or join the conversation on our Facebook page. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.